In this screencast, I'm going to show you how to calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient that we call U. And we use this overall heat transfer coefficient when we're trying to find the heat transfer rate from more than one mode of heat transfer. In this particular case, we're going to look at heat transfer due to conduction as well as convection. To calculate the U, we need to sum up all the thermal resistances and take the inverse of that number. And note that I put this as double prime, which means that our units are going to be meter squared Kelvin divided by watts. What are these heat transfer coefficients? Well, we're going to look at a composite plane wall of more than one material. And for the conduction, it's going to be the length of the wall that the heat transfer goes through divided by the thermal conductivity of the material. For convection, this is going to equal 1 over H, where H is the convective heat transfer coefficient. So let's look at an example of a composite wall. So here we have a plane wall made of three different materials, and we have convection on the outside. So we have a convective heat transfer coefficient. And for the first material, we have our thermal conductivity and the length the heat transfer goes through. And each one of these will have a different thermal conductivity and length. And finally, at the end of the wall, we have convection, so we have another convective heat transfer coefficient. Now let's calculate what our U is going to be. So our U is going to be 1 over H1 plus L1 over K1 plus L2 over K2 plus L3 over K3 plus finally our 1 over H2. And the sum of these are going to be raised to the minus 1. So this is an example if you have a plane wall.